It's been an exhausting couple of weeks. How do you summarize and how do you feel tonight?
It's been an exhausting almost 2.5 years. I don't feel great. I mean, I feel good over the fact that I've been vindicated, that now they know the story was not true. It was fabricated from day one. But I don't feel good because the SEALs are my unit, and I can't go out to a reunion anymore. And I've been to more SEAL reunions than I have high school reunions, and I've never missed a high school reunion. And I can't go now because that was the place I felt safe, and I don't anymore. That's been violated, Mark, and it can never be restored.
You said you didn't really want to go through with this. You were forced into it.
Yeah, I was forced into it. My back was against the wall. They would do nothing to restore my reputation. They wouldn't admit one inch that the story was fabricated. There was nothing else I could do was to take it to court, and that's the only way you can do it in our society to get the truth.
What about the witnesses who said they saw him throw the punch and knock you down?
There weren't any witnesses that saw me get hit and knocked down. There were none. There were a lot of people that said they thought there was a skirmish. There was a lot of other people. All of my witnesses, three of them were with me all night long. Two of them former SEALs and another SEAL's wife, and they all testified there was nothing like that that ever even took place that night. We have photographs. We have the whole ball of wax. To me, it was a slam dunk.
Were you nervous these last 48 hours that it was not going to go in your favor?
Sure you're nervous, because anytime a jury's out for over a week, you have no idea what's going through their minds. You don't know what's going on. But, you know, I thought the jury, you know, took their job serious, and the end result I'm pleased with, because my reputation's restored now. What's left of it.
Thanks, Jesse. Appreciate it very much.
Yeah, no problem.